We begin with new information on a story News 4 broke first on WYFF4.com.
A civil complaint has now been filed against a former Anderson County councilman alleging he was running a multi-million dollar Ponzi scheme with victims all across the country.
News 4's Mandy Gaither has been on this story from the beginning. She joins us now live and local from the Anderson newsroom. Mandy, tell us, what have you learned?
Well, I talked to an alleged victim tonight who says he knows of over 100 others who were victimized, and that's just in the Upstate. This thing is far spread. We're talking $70 million from investors in 25 states, and the state attorney general says there's one company behind it all.
We'll do a seminar here tonight.
People who invested in Ron Wilson's company say the former Anderson County councilman was still putting on seminars, trying to entice future investors even after a cease and desist order was filed by the state attorney general's office.
We had confidence in him. We thought he was a legitimate businessman. He was an entrepreneur. He had the best interest of the community at heart, we thought. And yet from the very beginning, he was lying to all of us.
Paul Brown, a well-known Anderson journalist and News 4 contributor, says he's one of countless victims in 25 states who invested an estimated $70 million in Wilson's business, Atlantic Bullion and Coin, Inc. The company, based in Easley, supposedly bought and sold gold and silver for investors. But the state attorney general says clients' account statements show Wilson was running a Ponzi scheme, showing he'd purchased silver for investors when, in fact, he had not, and using money from newer clients to pay older ones. Brown invested all his savings, but is more worried about those who gave most of what they had.
There are people out there, as a result of trusting Ron Wilson, whose lives are going to be devastated, and they may never get over it.
Another victim cited in the complaint is a 90-year-old man. His daughter says the money earned was being used to pay for the care of her mother, who has Alzheimer's.
I guess I'm numb and also maybe hopeful that maybe he can come up with all this money for all the other people. I'm just still hoping that it's, not going to ruin so many people's lives that are involved.
At this point, there's been no indictment, no arrest warrant for Wilson, just a civil complaint against him. But the investigation continues.
Now, I also talked to the agent in charge of the Greenville Secret Service. He says he's well aware of this case. The attorney general has also asked the court to impose a maximum fine of $10,000 per violation on Wilson and his business. I did reach out to Wilson for comment tonight, but wasn't able to get a hold of him. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson newsroom.